Uganda Revenue Authority directed that effective July there will be no more clearance of all motor vehicles older than 9 years from the date of manufacturing under the warehouse system.
The directive considered with the entry of DRC Congo into the East African Community, which provides and widens the market for our business community.
Instead, the clearance will be facilitated under the single customs territory arrangement, where taxes are paid upon arrival at the port into the East African Community in Mombasa or Dar es Salaam. This move is not welcomed by the car importers and dealers.
The business community usually does not have ready cash to execute transactions all through without resorting to borrowing.
Under their umbrella body of Kampala City Traders Association, they've come up in arms to oppose the ban, demanding that URA withdraws it with immediate effect.
While those clear that the port of entry will render uncompetitive on the market together with its revenue that had been coming in taxes.
The aggrieved traders base their arguments on 6 core points, including the Customs Act provides for 9 months as the warehousing period of any goods imported into the country, so the ban by URA is likely to render warehouses redundant.
This directive will therefore render all warehouses empty and redundant, since there will be nothing to warehouse enough more, and this renders this investment portfolio affected.
The directive coincides with the entry of the DRC into the East African Community, which is likely to affect the execution of business among the member countries. A number of vehicles in transit have been stolen even before their final clearance, which raises more fears once final clearance is done at the port.
A number of vehicles in transit have been stolen even before their final clearance, which raises more fears once final clearance is done, thus taxes paid at the port of entry.
There's also loss of 3,000 jobs in the sector, loss of re-export business, and the ban will cause an increase in the cost of vehicles on the market.
To over 3,000 people in this sector, especially casual laborers and many others who constitute a big percentage, without mentioning the families and other dependents.
The affected vehicles are those stipulated under Part B of the Traffic and Road Safety Act 1998. The legal instrument banning the importation of old vehicles came into effect on 1st July 2018, following the amendment of the 1998 Traffic and Road Safety Act. This report was compiled by Jaliat Namuaya for the news. For the miracle you